how you can book stunning accommodations anywhere in the world, and that too at affordable costs, coming up. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Sri Lankan Travel Series. If you are new to this channel or do not know me, my name is Alankar and I run this channel, The Globster, where I upload a travel video every week, including vlogs, travel tricks and hacks which can help you to bring out the most of your holidays and vacations. So if you like this video, consider subscribing. In this video, I'm going to talk about a particular platform where you can find extraordinary accommodations which look like this and which offers views like these, and that too at a very affordable price. So the name of this platform is AirBnB. Some of you might have heard of it, but many of you might have not, because before coming here, I had talked to my friends and others about it, and most of them did not know or hear about this app before. So I thought, why not make a video on this during this trip here in Sri Lanka. So why do I need to make a different video on another platform called AirBnB, where I have already made a accommodation related video on Couchsurfing, which provides free accommodation anywhere in the world. The main difference between AirBnB and Couchsurfing is that in Couchsurfing, it's good for solo travelers or backpackers or a small group of travelers, but not all people who are watching this video right now might be solo travelers or backpackers like me. Some people might like to go out and have a vacation with their family or friends, so they travel in larger groups. For them especially, Couchsurfing is most probably not going to work, because the hosts who are hosting on Couchsurfing, they do not have so much of space in their homes to accommodate so many people. They mostly accommodate one or two at max. However, there are hosts who have more space and can accommodate 4 to 5 people as well. For example, my host Michael, who was in Kandy, if you don't know him or haven't watched that video, I'll link that video down in the description again. You can go and have a look. So his home was quite a big one, and he has hosted 5 to 6 people before as well, but not all hosts can actually do that. And not only that, not all people who are going to come on a vacation to anywhere in the world, not only Sri Lanka, might not look for a cheap accommodation or budget options like that. Maybe some of you just want to come here on a vacation and enjoy yourself as much as possible, and you know, stay at the best locations and get the best views and all. So since my channel is meant to provide value to all sorts of viewers, not just solo travelers and backpackers, I am specifically making a video on AirBnB, and this is a platform, an app, a website, whatever you call it, which is certainly going to live up to your expectations. So first, you need to go to the website of AirBnB or download an app, which is a better option. So you download that app from Google Play Store, and you make your own profile, and there and then whenever you are going to a certain location, for example, you are coming here in Sri Lanka, so you for whichever city you want an accommodation in, suppose Colombo, so, or suppose in Mirissa, right now I'm in Mirissa, so you go to the search bar, type Mirissa, you will get a lot of listings and you can choose from there. But one thing you must remember, that this is not a free accommodation like Couchsurfing, but this can prove to be extremely affordable, and some of these accommodations and hotels actually provide the best experiences to the guests. For example, there are Airbnbs which are, suppose, beach shacks, treetop houses, homestays. Some are located in 5-star hotels. I personally stayed at one of the Airbnbs in Malaysia, in Kuala Lumpur, and that was a 5-star hotel, that too with an infinity pool on the rooftop, and trust me, it cost me only 700 Indian rupees per night. So you don't get such cheap kind of accommodation with such amazing views and amenities. So after you type the name of the location on your search bar, when you see the listings and make a choice of the listing you want to stay in, you select that and you choose the dates and you message the host of that Airbnb. So in most cases the host actually reply within 1 or 2 days, and after having a conversation with them, you can go and book your stay. But I should also be mentioning one thing, that if you are a solo traveler, then it is slightly, you know, the cost is on the higher side, because what happens is, when these Airbnbs are usually apartments or guest houses, and as I said, villas and stuff like that, so they usually can accommodate around 5 to 6 people. So if you are traveling with your family, or if you are traveling in a group of friends, then it is easier for you to, you know, the cost is split. Because when I was in Malaysia, in that particular 5-star hotel I was talking about, we were six of us, so the cost actually was split between all the six of us. So it cost me only around 700 rupees per night. But if you are alone in any trip, then it is difficult for you to find budget accommodations in Airbnb. However, the only reason why I am staying in an Airbnb here in Sri Lanka, although I have come alone, is so that I can make this video, because initially I had not thought that I would stay in an Airbnb. I was only looking for hostels and couch surfing. But then I thought that I need to make a video on Airbnb to share with you guys. So this is the only reason why I am staying here in an Airbnb. And today it is going to cost me 1200 Indian rupees for one night. I have used this platform not only in Malaysia, in Kuala Lumpur, but also in the Pangkor Islands, then in Gangtok, Sikkim, in India itself, where I stayed with my friends, my college friends, in a homestay. Then again, I went to Russia for the World Cup, where I again stayed in an Airbnb in both Moscow and Kazan. And every time, I must say this, every time I have been fascinated by the kind of experiences I have had. So if you are in a family or a group of friends, an Airbnb is must for you to stay. Otherwise, honestly speaking, your trip will be kind of incomplete. Once you get to know about this app, you will start using it more frequently and probably every time. One thing which is very common between Airbnb platform as well as Couchsurfing is that you are going to stay with a host. In Airbnbs, usually the hosts are not staying with you. There is some other rooms assigned for people coming over to stay in an Airbnb. But even in some cases, you might have to share the same apartment, not the same room, but the same apartment with your host, who is the owner of that Airbnb. So the question of whether it's safe to use or not, and whether you can trust the host, comes up, because this is one thing that people always have an issue with using Couchsurfing, because some of them consider it might not be safe to use it, and the same thing applies here as well. So I have made a video on Couchsurfing before, where I have shared the tips or advices which you can use to ensure that your stay in a Couchsurfing host is going to be a fruitful one and a memorable one, and nothing wrong is going to happen. The same advices or the same tips apply here as well. So I'm not going to repeat that. I'll link that video down in the description below. You can go and have a look after watching this video. But I'm going to explain the same thing, the issue about whether you can trust your host or not, in a slightly different perspective this time. So I am going to give an example of what the CEO of Airbnb said in his TED Talk. If you have not watched that TED Talk yet, I'm going to link that video down in the description as well. So you can have a look, you can go and watch that full TED Talk after watching this video. So this is his example that he gave. So while he was on stage giving that TED Talk, he actually did a social experiment on the stage itself. So what he told was, he asked the entire audience sitting in their auditorium to take out their phone from their pocket. So everybody took out their phones from their pocket, and then he told them to unlock their phones, and everybody did the same, just as he said. And after unlocking their phones, he said that now all of you hand over your unlocked phones to the person sitting on your left. You might understand where he was actually coming from. So all of them started laughing and understood the point he was trying to make. And all of them actually handed their unlocked phones to the left. But after that, no one was looking at him. They were all looking at the phones, because you can understand, like, if you give your unlocked phone to some other stranger, you will always be tense. Like, he might search your gallery, he might, text something wrong to someone else, things like that. So this is something you know that it is unsafe. But suppose you knew that the person you are giving that phone to is a professional in terms of handling other people's unlocked phones. How would you know that? Suppose you have a lot of reviews to read about that particular person. So this entire Airbnb app, Airbnb platform, or even Couchsurfing, these entire apps run on the basis of reviews and references. Couchsurfing is all about references, whereas in Airbnb, it's about reviews. So before you book a host, before you message the host, you actually go through the reviews that particular listing has. And you will find that whether the reviews are good or not. So for example, that person who was taking your phone, unlocked phone, had around 150 reviews, where other people have said that person manages unlocked phones of other people very well. He doesn't do anything wrong with it. So you will feel more confident while giving your unlocked phone to that person. The same concept applies in Airbnb and Couchsurfing, both in both the platforms. So you book your hotels based on the references that that host has or based on the reviews that this particular Airbnb has. And once you read that other people have come and stayed over there and have given positive reviews about that listing, then you will always feel more confident and you will be excited about staying there. I mean, no, you will be sure that nothing wrong is going to happen. But if you do not find a lot of reviews about that particular listing or if it is an absolute new one, you might not go and book it. So it's up to you. You are under no obligation whatsoever. So that is all what I had to say about Airbnb. But the video is not over yet. Right now I'm going to go to my place where I'm staying today, which is an Airbnb. And I'm going to take you through a room tour of my apartment. As I said that Airbnbs are fabulous, and although I have come here alone, this is why I chose to book a moderately priced Airbnb. But if I had come with a group of say 3-4 friends, there are way more better Airbnbs on offer. So that's all from this video. Hope you liked it and hope you find this information really useful for you in future. I'll see you next time. Until then, goodbye. We'll be right back.